want me to think that you ain't talking about me with them. And every time you come back to me, you telling me something they said, but you never told me what you said in my defense. Stop worrying about people not liking you. Some of us really need to come to the altar on the day of Pentecost. Before we receive the Holy Ghost, we need to get delivered from people. Somebody walked, I've never seen so much petty stuff going on in the church because somebody walked by you and they forgot to speak. Now all of a sudden your Holy Ghost is all jacked up. You can't pray now. She didn't speak to me. What did you speak to her? You saw her just like you thought she saw you. Now, of course, when I was coming along, the junior always spoke to the senior. We don't teach our children that no more. But the junior already spoke to the senior, and you walked by the mother and didn't open your mouth. You got popped in your mouth because obviously it ain't working, and I didn't see if it's working. But nowadays, we let our children do what we do. Because we are, I'm going to say we don't set no examples, but we do. We set the example because we walk by people and don't speak. In the car and talk about her. I don't know who she thinks she was today, even looking like that. But what? And now you wonder why your children don't like it. They see a nigga rolling their eyes, they're grown folk. And then when they come tell you something, not my baby, I know, but you know that was your baby. You told them that foolishness. First Peter 5:8-9. He says this. Be sober. Be vigilant, because the adversary, the devil, not Sister Green Bean, not Brother Peanut. I know you like Junebug, but it ain't Junebug. He said the adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion. And see, here's the problem that we have, because he said as a roaring lion, and we think it's really a roaring lion. It's in my book. I don't know if it's in your book. It says as a roaring lion. What that means is he's not a roaring lion. He only appears to be a roaring lion. As a matter of fact, he's known a whole lot of roaring, but I messed around, put my glasses on, and looked in his mouth. He ain't got no teeth. He can't hurt me. He's just making a whole lot of noise to distract me. And many of the people of God are being distracted by the roaring, but he can't do nothing to me. Okay, I'm not ready. You take him with your text. He said, be sober. Be vigilant, because the adversary of the devil as a roaring lion walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resisteth steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in the brethren that are in the world. But you gotta understand, the devil, he's looking for you. Y'all didn't know that, did you? He's looking for you. And the thing about it is, some of y'all hard to find. You know why you're hard to find? Because you're in his camp. But the real folk, he's looking for you, and you're not hard to find, because there is something about the children of God. There's a mark that's on you. And I don't care where you are. I remember when I got saved, but I still wanted to do the club. And some of y'all were like me. You get in the club, and you forget that you're in the club, and the music come on, you start. No, that's not what we do here. You know, you're in the wrong place. You're sticking out like a sore thumb. So even though I wanted to be in the club, there was a mark that was on me that was undeniable. But some of y'all, there ain't no mark. There ain't no mark. And so he's looking for you. And when he looks for you, he's putting a plan together to destroy you, to get you off the mark, to get you distracted. And that's what the devil does. But see, you have to understand the reason why some of us fall into his traps. It's not because he hit us at face value. The first thing he does is he distracts us with petty stuff. And while we're focusing on things that don't matter, he slips in with the whammy. Do I have any witnesses in here? Well, I got to get here. The Message Bible says it like this, and then I got to go. It says, keep a cool head. Stay alert. See, that's what the saints of y'all sleep. I've never seen so many sleep saints in all my life. You don't even, you look at the news, but you don't know what's going on. because you're focusing in on the wrong stuff. You're focusing in on who done killed Junebug across the water, but you ain't looking at what's going on in Israel. You're not looking at what's going on there, because that's the kind of stuff that tells me I'm getting ready to get my wings. I'm getting ready to get up out of here. Y'all keep on acting a fool, but the Lord is on his way back. And so I'm focused on, I wish I had some witnesses. But he says, keep a cool head. Don't get all excited when the devil start acting a fool. Keep a cool head. He says the devil is poised to pounce and will like nothing better than to catch you napping, to catch you off guard. But you got to keep your guard up. You're not only the one that's going through hard times. See, it's not only also the people that are going through hard times. It's some of these folk that look like you on the mountaintop, but the devil is trying to get you. You know it. On Thursday you was okay, but on Friday it looked like all hell broke loose and you trying to figure out what happened. It's because you were distracted on Thursday. Yes. Okay. Stop walking around, people of God, with your head hung down, thinking that you are the only one. You're the only one going through. You're walking around with your head in the sand like you're the only one having a hard time. I wish people here would be honest and tell your neighbor, I got a little something going on too. Look at another and tell them, you ain't the only one. But people are walking around and you get in the church look like they can suck beans through a Coke bottle because they all upset by what they're going through, and you think you're the only one. You're not the only one that the devil's messing with. If you're trying to live holy, he's messing with you too. But people are walking around and what's happening is a whole lot of people are walking around, but they're looking for a pity party. They're looking for somebody to pat them on the back and rub them up and down. Ain't nobody got time to be rubbing you up and down. If you get your face before God, you won't be all right. You're walking around like your children the only one acting out. Mine acting out too. My business. I don't care if you go tell anybody more. I got a boy. Some of y'all catch that next week. This little Negro, Lord, done lost their mind. I'm the preacher. I'm the pastor. I'm trying to save somebody else's children. And my boy, I'm able to black him out. Just tell him what's up. So I want you to understand, you ain't the only one. The pastor got some problems too. The missionary got some problems. You're not the only one. We just found out where to go. Where do I go when the things are acting up all around? I go to the rock because I know he's able. I go to the rock. You are not the only one that's dealing with stuff. So many people come to church, Lord, they look bad. Y'all ever seen anybody come to church and you look at them like, oh my Lord. You can almost say, ooh, that baby's going through. But why? Why do we got to come to church? Now, don't get me wrong. I know that there are people hurting, and that's like the people that come and show their hurt. There are people that's coming in here, they're smiling, but they're hurting. And so we miss them while we focus on the one that's trying to get attention. And we can't see the ones. They're trying to do the right thing. They're trying to praise God through it. All they need is somebody to encourage them and say, baby, you can make it. But we ain't trying to talk to them because we worried about something. Oh, Lord, lazy being. But you are not the only one. Stop acting like you're the only one. As a matter of fact, you may be going through a trial, but I guarantee you there's about four or five other people on your row. I'm not just talking about in the church, but on your row, there's about four or five other people that are going through. That's why you've got to stay alert. That's why you've got to understand that it's not just me, but it's because I got a mark on me. That the devil is trying to destroy me. I told him this morning the reason why He's trying to do it because he understands if you ever walk into your destiny, if you ever become what God called you to be, you're going to destroy his kingdom. You're going to cause him some problems. And so he's trying to stop you before you ever realize who you really are. Okay. You've got to understand that there is a blessing in your going through. There's a blessing in your going. I'm trying to move here, but I've learned that in the church, we don't know how to go through. We don't know how to go through in the church because we think that we're supposed to come here looking bad. We thought we're supposed to just, you know, pull our clothes out the dry. I ain't ironing today because I'm going through. You thought that because you're going through that you can, you know, Mr. Zest and you ain't got any relationship no more, so you ain't got to, you know, you ain't got to visit Zest before you come. Yeah. You think because you're going through, you don't have to, you know. And so you come in here looking bad, smelling bad, and then acting bad. And you want everybody to pay attention to you. And then you wonder why people are moving from the road that you own. And you say, well, they're supposed to love everybody. I love you, but I'm going to love you on this side over here. But you come in here because you want everybody to know that you are going through. And then as soon as I said, the girl was up here, wait, sweet baby's up here to give the word. She said, praise the Lord, everybody. Can I tell y'all something? I'm going to help y'all. When she said, praise the Lord, you're not supposed to say, praise the Lord, back. You're supposed to say, glory, thank you, hallelujah, hey, thank you. But what y'all do? Praise the Lord. She said, praise the Lord, everybody. Well, praise the Lord. But when is somebody going to praise him?
That's right.
But what they do is they come in here looking bad and say, praise the Lord, and they just like, and you move to the next thing.
Yes.
Well, you ain't gonna get the next thing until you get this.
That's right.
But you ain't the one.
That's right.
I'm going through, but I still visit Mr. Sess. I'm going through, but you know, me and Chris, we got a thing going on, and it's all up in here. Lord, don't let them go on a fast.
Oh, mercy.
Okay, let me get back to this text here. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. See, here's what happened. See, y'all are upset. You come to church all mad and down in the dumps because somebody been talking about you falsely. They told the truth on me. I don't know about y'all. But anyway, they coming here talking about you falsely, persecuting you, and you all upset. But that ain't what the Bible told us to do.
That's right.
This is what it said. The very next verse, it says, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. You got stuck on that part, he said, when they shall talk about you and say all manner of things evil against you. You stuck right there. But he told us, when they do that, come to church and rejoice. And then James came back and he told us in James 1, he said, count it. That's why I don't understand why you coming into church looking like you looking. If you count it all joy, joy don't look like that. All right, I got to get to this text. I gotta get to this text. James picked it up and he said, blessed is the man that endured temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised him that loved him.
Yes, sir.
You've got to know who you are and who you are. I'm not afraid in the church, people don't know who they are, and they don't know whose they are. Because if you were really a king's kid, then you will act like a king's kid. I ain't talking about PKs now, because y'all said you're a preacher's kid, y'all like, but preacher's kids, they mad. Maybe not your chair. I'm talking about mine. I ain't talking about y'all pastor chair. I'm talking about my chair. They bad.